You'll likely recognize this plant, and this is Platycerium bifurcatum. And bifurcatum means that it's just branches that are dividing, and I do believe that means that these little branches that kind of divide off of it. This is an incredible epiphytic species. I do have to say that the first one I ever got, which was many years ago, I actually lost just from pure neglect of it. And it's one of those things that you do have to stay on top of it. You will notice that this is mounted. You do get them quite commonly as mounts or in the store, or you could actually get them in a soil mixture. Either one is absolutely fine. If you have one that's on a mount like this with some sphagnum, you're going to want to, what I do with a lot of my mounts with sphagnum is I put kind of water over it and I let it soak, and then I kind of let it air out a little bit. It's often common I will bring this into my shower. So even though this lives on my kitchen wall underneath a light and near my northeast facing window, I will sometimes bring it occasionally into the shower and just kind of like shower, get a little bit more of the humidity up. This is a plant that's actually native throughout Australia, and I think it's actually goes up through New Guinea, and maybe it goes through Indonesia. I'm not quite sure, but I do definitely know that it's within Australia. It's kind of like the epicenter of it. And you'll notice that it has this kind of mealy look to its leaves, mealy meaning that kind of like whitish hue shade. Also, let me show you the new leaves coming in. So you'll see that the new leaves kind of have a little bit more of that whitish kind of hairy, mealy texture to it. And this is a plant that doesn't dry out intensely easily. You know, again, this is growing in a little bit more of an epiphytic kind of way. So you wanna make sure that it gets a little bit of water and then kind of airs out. Very similar to like a tillandsia or other kind of plant that has been mounted. You'll see like dischidias, ashcananthuses, oftentimes that are mounted that are hemiepiphytic or completely epiphytic. And you, again, it's very easy to kind of kill if you just forget on watering completely and then it just kind of dries out. And the shields, like these little shields right here that you see, will start to dry out. But some of that drying out is actually quite beautiful. Now, if your shield dries out, you know, don't worry about it. That's kind of like part of the natural course of these things. But if the shield is nice and green and happy, you're probably taking really good care of it. But if you actually go onto kind of the interwebs and onto social media and onto Instagram, you'll see, especially a lot of folks from Japan, revere kind of the Platycerium, which is, again, it's a type of fern, so it actually propagates a little bit more by spores. Even the ones that have passed or have died, there's like this certain set of like reverence for the plant and how it looks in all its glory. And you'll see ones that are different species that are coronariums, one that comes to mind that is actually quite beautiful with beautiful leaves. These are a little bit more of, you know, kind of this typical leaf shape, but some that look at a little bit more like fern leaves and have like lots of different types of, I mean, I don't know, what's the typical fern leaf? There's so many different types of fern leaves. Just a little bit more undulations to the leaf. This one is a little bit more known as Elkhorn fern or Staghorn fern. But of course, a lot of other Platyceriums come with that common name. So it's not one that you'd actually be able to go by. Now, as far as fertilizing this goes, you could give it more like a 1-1-1, 10-10-10, really dilute it down. And when you're doing a little bit more of the watering, then you could get that into the mixture during the spring and summer seasons. I've let this go without water for a couple weeks. I wouldn't really push it any more than that. Just because, like I said, you know, it's one of those things that I'm a little shy to do now because, like I said, the first one kind of perished on me and it was just because of pure neglect. So the second time around, this one's doing a lot better and has some really beautiful growth to it and probably will continue to get beautiful growth as it goes into the spring and summer seasons.